Jai Sri Krishna. And today let us talk about love, immortal love, and then again immortalized in kalams, Sindhi kalams. Sindhi kalams is poetry, and very often it talks about lovers, but then it has got a double meaning in the sense that when you hear about the yearning of the lover for the beloved, actually we are talking also about a bhakta, an aspirant in the spiritual path, yearning for the Lord. It can have a double meaning. But I believe there is a place in Pakistan now, where in Sindh really, where we have heard the story of Saswi Punnu. These are immortalized, and let me tell you the story. Now Saswi was born a Hindu. She was the baby, and the baby was placed in a wooden box and thrown in the Indus River, as the father did not like a prophecy. Obviously, what was said about the girl on the obviously the father did not like. So they decided to put her in a wooden box and throw her into the river. So there, on the lower floor of the river, there was a rich city called Bhambur. And there lived a washerman whose name was Muhammad. He had no child. While washing clothes, he saw the floating box. When he opened the box, he saw a beautiful baby who he called Saswi. And Saswi means the moon, and he had decided to adopt her. As Saswi grew into a damsel, a beautiful woman, and she became the talk of the town. So a prince, Punnu, heard about the beauty and was curious enough to see Saswi. So the prince came as a merchant to Bhambur, and when Saswi came to buy something, their eyes met and they fell in love. And with the consent of Saswi's parents, they got married. It seems that the parents said that you have to live with us, because obviously this was their only child. And another thing is that it seems that the prince learned to be a washerman. But anyway, the couple lived happily for a while. The news of the wedding reached the father of Punnu, who was most upset and wanted Punnu back at any cost. He sent three of Punnu's brothers to bring him back, but Punnu refused. The brothers got Punnu drunk, drugged, until he lost his senses. Then they just placed Punnu on a camel's back and took him back to Kech. Kech is obviously the city where they came from. In an agonized state of mind, Saswi left Bhambur and decided to follow Punnu all by herself. She walked over rocks and mountains and camel men's tracks. Hungry and thirsty and with bruised feet, she walked on and on. When she reached a place called Sangherpat, she saw a shepherd called Eel, who looked at her with evil intentions. She prayed to be helped, and the earth opened up and swallowed her up. A piece of a cloth was, however, visible where she was swallowed up by the earth. A piece of cloth remained visible. And the shepherd who saw this and saw what had happened was repentant. So he made a grave for Saswi and looked after the grave. And it is said that they do not die again who died before they were to die. And this is a song that I often sing also in Sindhi, which it says, Je Allah sa milan chahin, jiyare pana ke mar, which means that if you want to meet God while alive, then you have to kill yourself while alive, which actually means killing your ego, killing your desires. But this story about love is something else. Now, seeing that Punnu was so miserable without Saswi, the father allowed him to return to Bhambur. As he returned, he passed Sangherpat area, and there he met the shepherd who told him what had happened. Now, Punnu was Puno collapsed with shock and grief when he heard about his Susvi following him through rocks and mountains and stones to reach him. So Puno collapsed with shock and grief and prayed that he should be united with his love. And wonder of wonders, the earth opened up once again and he was taken in. Death united them, never to be parted again. And there is a place, it seems, where it says that immortal love of Sasve Punu, where it seems they are both engraved. And today maybe there is a place of worship there. But today what I'm going to do is I'm going to have my friend Meenu Gidwani, who sings these kalams so very beautifully. I sing it again, but now I can't sing that well. And it is, Pere Pavandi San, Chavandi San, Rahi Vanyurat Bhambhora Me. That means, obviously, this is the words sung by Sasvi as she walked over rocks and mountains and begged her loved one, Punu, to return to her and stay the night in Bhambhor. So I give you Meenu Gidwani.
Devya nahi akhe saman suran ja nind me sumhare munje punho akhe munja ne rakhni vya pere pavandi sa pere pavandi sa pere pavandi sa allah chavandi sa pere pavandi sa allah chavandi sa rahi ban raat bhambhor me allah rahi ban raat bhambhor me pere pavandi sa uthat aariya jam ja अदियों जाम जा सरतियों जाम जा पुनहल जाम जा वागू वठंदी सान मत चवंदी सान वागू वठंदी सान अल्लाह चवंदी सान रही बन रात भंभोर में अल्लाह रही बन रात भंभोर में पेरे पवन दीसा चढ़ी त जबल चोट ते भलो जबल चोट ते सरतियों चोट ते अदियों चोट ते भेनर चोट ते जबल चोट ते सदरा कंदी सान अल्लाह चवंदी सान सदरा कंदी सान मत चवंदी सान रही बन रात भंभोर में अल्लाह रही बन रात भंभोर में पेरे पवन दीसा अदियों शाह लतीफ जे ओ भिट जो घोट लतीफ जे ओ लालण लाल लतीफ जे लाल लतीफ जे शाह लतीफ जे सुहिणो लतीफ जे अदियो लतीफ जे गोले लहंदी सान मत चवंदी सान गोले लहंदी सान अल्लाह चवंदी सान रही वन रात भंभोर में अल्लाह रही वन रात भंभोर में पेरे पवंदी सान मत चवंदी सान फेरे पवंदी सान मत चवंदी सान रही वन रात भंभोर में अल्लाह रही वन रात भंभोर में अल्लाह रही वन रात भंभोर।